Hello, Sentinels. Welcome to Mountain Ridge News. I'm Liam Owens.
And I'm Henry Stedman.
Watch it on the news. What you gonna do? I could hit refresh and forget. Used to keep it cool. Should I keep it light? Stay out of the fight. No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song, preaching what is wrong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light?
Well, guys, it's February, so how are those New Year's resolutions coming along?
Caden and Cody bring you Nick in the Halls with a reminder of your New Year's resolutions.
Interview. Program. Hey.
New Year in the Nick. Nick in the New Year. We're gonna ask him questions.
You have a New Year's resolution?
Game.
Hey, your New Year's resolution?
Huh?
New Year's resolution?
I have to kiss my grandpa.
Hey, do any of you guys have New Year's resolutions?
To get big at the gym. To be happy. What's that?
New Year's resolution.
See.
New Year's resolutions?
I don't know.
New Year's resolution. Hey, do you guys have New Year's? Oh, not? All right, then. Hey. Yo,
With that, happy Valentine's Day.
Or as I like to call it, Singles Awareness Day.
Well, if you're single, here's some things to do in February.
Aiden and Avery bring you a story on that.
Hey there, Sentinels. It's February, which means that we're still in the middle of winter, but it's not summer yet, and it's not warm, and it's not Christmas anymore, so,
Oh, that was smooth.
This is dumb.
Oh.
Feel the morning on my face. Ain't a pill that I.
Let's try this one more time.
And there you have it, Sentinels. Five things that'll occupy you for at least an hour in February. Yeah.
So, Kendry, what else is going on this month?
Well, Liam, since you asked, I bring to you a story on Black History.
So, Ms. Rugman, why do you think it's important for us to talk about Black History Month and gain, like, a knowledge of it?
Yeah, I think it's really important. Sometimes, you know, we're only really focusing on our own perspectives throughout history or things that relate to us. And Black History Month really gives us time to look into other perspectives and really kind of get more pieces of the story, if that makes sense.
Yeah, for sure. So in your class, do you discuss Black History Month? And like, if so, what parts of it do you highlight?
I would say that we're really conscious as a department on really focusing on Black history and highlighting it throughout the entire year. But we also really try to focus on Black History Month specifically and highlight people that we might not as talk about as much, like Thurgood Marshall or Jackie Robinson, maybe people that the students themselves can relate to a lot more than maybe just talking about people in the 1800s.
So how can we as high school students like learn more about Black history? Like what can we get involved in?
Yeah, I think it's really important to reach out to your teachers because they're going to have a lot of resources that you can look up to learn more about Black people's achievements and also the history that they've gone through. But some that I can think of off the top of my head is you can visit websites under the NAACP, or also the Smithsonian has awesome resources that you can go ahead and view and reach out to your local community and see if there's anything that you can do.
Yeah, for sure. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview.
Thank you, teachers, for your insight.
Girls basketball. Great.
Jeremy and Charlie bring you a story about girls basketball.
Back at it again, here with the girls' basketball story. Here we have
Meg Cummings. I'm the captain and the only senior.
How's the season going so far for you guys?
It's going really well. Actually, I'm really proud of the effort they put in. It's going really well so far. We're getting a lot of wins.
How's the team building so far?
It's pretty good. There's a lot of freshmen, so it's kind of like, yeah, we're young, but I don't know.
What's your favorite part about being on this basketball team?
I think a big part is building the friendships that we create. Being competitive is a big thing.
What's up, Ms. Herbert? What do you think on the girls' basketball team this year?
I think we have a lot of progression from the past couple years, and I'm excited to see what the future holds.
Alright, Coach Newman, what is your philosophy behind coaching basketball?
Philosophy? I think the number one thing is I just want girls to get out there and play hard. Play with a lot of heart and hustle, and then the rest kind of comes together by doing that. So that's the main philosophy, is getting them to play hard, play with heart and hustle, and play for each other.
And how's the season been so far?
It's been really good, actually. We're a young team. We've got one senior and then a couple juniors helping lead us along the way. But with being a new school, we started with not winning a game our first year. And then last year with only 3 wins, and this year we're actually 10-4. So off to a good start, and 1-2 going into region play. So.
Our school sports teams are all hungry.
One specific wrestler has had a standout season.
He did highlights for Kaiser Garcia.
All right, so you're on the wrestling team, is that correct?
I am.
And last year we heard about you had a broken leg and you decided to wrestle on that. Can you kind of tell me more of what was going through your mind when that happened?
Yeah, so we had a big tournament here, and I was in the semifinals wrestling number 5 kid in the country. I was 6 at the time, and you know, kind of got into a weird position, and my leg snapped, and I know it seemed like my season was going to be over, and I don't know, kind of talked with my coaches a little bit, and talked to my dad, and it was kind of a decision I made on my own, and you know, gave it my best go. I ended up taking 3rd at state. I lost by 1 point to the kid who won, but gave it a good try, I guess.
So, just from that story alone, I can tell that you kind of determined. So do you feel like that reflects on everything else you do in life?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. I mean, I try to get my best, especially with, you know, with wrestling, with school, just, you know, do the best I can.
And it sounds like you're kind of just powering through everything. Like, everything's, I guess, like the odds are against you, I guess you could say, but you still got 3rd place, which is really good. So are you kind of looking forward for this season?
Yeah, for sure. So I mean, I won state freshman year, so I'm looking to repeat. We have divisionals this weekend, and then state's going to be in 2 weeks, so that's the plan.
So you're just going to keep working hard and then try and take state this year then?
Yeah, for sure.
That's good.
Yeah, we're always looking for new guys on our team, so if you're willing to come out, I mean, wrestling's going to teach you to work hard and, you know, push through tough things in your life. I know I've been through a lot, and without this sport, I don't know where I'd be. So if you get the chance, swing by and see if you like it or not.
That was fine.
That takes some real athleticism.
Hey, no, I'm pretty athletic too.
Speaking of athletes, the 2022 Winter Olympics are this year.
And I snowboard. Beijing 2022, I'm coming for you.
Okay, perfect.
It's been really, really fun. I think the choreography is my favorite part so far.
I am here today with the co-music director of Seussical, Mr. Morgan Parker. How have you been liking Seussical this year?
I love Seussical. It's one of my favorite shows. It's great.
What's your favorite song in Seussical?
I really like Oh, the Things You Can Think, the opening number.
That's pretty generic.
It's fun.
That is okay.
It is pretty generic.
I have one last question for you. Was the moon landing real?
No, it was fake. There's no way.
But.
Are you kidding me? We can't solve, like, world hunger, but we can fly to the moon? Doesn't make sense.
Heard right here in DeHaan's office. Thank you.
Hi, my name is AJ Colling, and I am a Wickersham in Seussical. I've been loving it. It's so much fun, and just getting to have that cast bond, it's just so much fun. We're really working hard, producing a great show, and I'm really excited just to go out and see it. I just love the camaraderie of everyone has, and I just love how fun the show is, and just how fun everyone around me is in that cast.
How were the pyramids built?
By Egyptians, I guess.
Wrong, aliens.
Hey Kendrick, did you know that our school has a new police officer?
No, I didn't. Let's hear more about that from Jacob.
What is your name?
It's Officer Jake Burns.
Why did you become an officer here at Mountain Ridge?
Most of my career I've worked in schools. I've been in a couple other schools. And when Officer Tesoros, he got promoted to detective, the spot opened up, and when I talked to him, he loves Mountain Ridge. And so I had to come over and see what it's all about.
So what motivates you to keep the students safe here?
That's a tough question. I think I just wanted to, I had kind of a couple rough issues when I was growing up, and when I become a cop, I thought I just wanted to give back to maybe help prevent some of those issues from happening to other kids. That's kind of why I got into it.
What do you think would be like the problem that's like the most concerning?
I've only been in Mountain Ridge for about a week now, so it's hard to say. I think in general with students, especially high school students, mental health is a big deal. I probably deal with mental health more than I do drugs or fights or anything else. And I think it's one issue that has the most to lose. You know, you get caught with drugs, it's, you know, it might sting for a couple days and that's it. Or if I don't catch you with drugs, you get away with it, you go smoke or whatever, and on you go. But if I don't catch you when you're having a rough day, like that could be it. And so that's one that concerns me the most, is just hoping we can catch everybody who's having rough days, rough times, and see what we can do to help them.
This next story needs no introduction.
How difficult would you say art is?
I don't think it's necessarily too difficult. You just have to be willing to put in the time to make your artwork good.
What if I feel like I'm not creative enough or am not motivated to make art? What should you do then?
Okay, well, I think that especially in classes like my classes, I'll usually give you a prompt or some guidelines to start your project. And then you can always like ask people around you. You can always look up ideas on the internet to kind of get references from. There are a lot of different ways to kind of spark your imagination and creativity.
What would be a good way to begin doing art at home?
Well, I think that a really good way to do art at home is just to either follow step-by-step tutorials online or to draw along with YouTube videos is a really good place to start, especially if all of your materials are just pencils and colored pencils. That can be a really good place to start because you can make really cool stuff with just paper and colored pencils or regular pencils.
What should you do if you're a beginner and you want to get into art?
I think just start by taking a class in high school, and then from there, then your high school teacher should be able to kind of steer you in the right direction, tell you what other classes you can take to build up your portfolio or just build up your skill set that you're trying to work on.
What is your favorite art medium?
Right now, I'm really into pointillism. That's just like doing the individual dots of art with just micron pens. I think it's really fun. That's what we're doing in my drawing one and drawing two classes right now.
So what does this class do? We do ceramics, which basically means we work with clay, and then we fire it, and it becomes ceramics after that.
How difficult would you say it is to do this class?
I would say that it starts out fairly basic to where anybody can do it. And really, the techniques that I teach, it makes it so that anybody can advance with it, move on to higher levels, or do more things.
Internet is pretty sweet. In just a few minutes, Maggie can find summer jobs she likes and get tips on how to apply. Then she finds a video clip of an author she's been studying in English class. Next, she watches the latest Lady Gaga video. Of course, there's plenty of stuff on the internet that Maggie doesn't want to see. One time, she was doing a report on the Iraq War, and she ended up seeing a lot of really graphic pictures of war injuries. Maggie also knows that people put up pictures of nudity and sex. Maggie wants to avoid seeing that stuff. It makes her uncomfortable, and oh my gosh, what if her brother walked by? So what should Maggie do? After all, the internet should be a cool place to learn about stuff and have a good time. Maggie decides to talk to her dad about her worries. Together, they learn how to do searches online that help Maggie avoid stuff she doesn't want to see. For example, she learns that Google allows you to filter out inappropriate content when you search. Plus, Maggie's dad learns about software that he can install on the home computer that blocks bad stuff. Maggie and her dad agree that G or PG rated websites make the family computer a better place for Maggie and her brother to do schoolwork. Of course, coming across inappropriate pictures on the web isn't the only thing that might go wrong on the internet or in the real world. Someone might send you a nude picture or nasty text message on your cell phone. Maybe somebody calls you and says things that make you feel crappy. Or maybe someone creates a website that rips on one of your friends. Or someone you know might write on his or her blog that they're planning to do something dangerous at school. If you ever experience anything that makes you uncomfortable, upset, or scared, the best thing to do is tell a person you trust. Think of the people who have your back when bad things happen and talk to them about it, even if you need to do it anonymously. The point is, to stay safe online and in the real world, everybody needs help. Don't be afraid to reach out to the people in your life that are there for you when things get weird and uncomfortable.